Based on interviews with the defectors, the impression we get is that the IS has been very influential in the evolution and transformation of Boko Haram, and notably of ISWAP.
Two Nigerian soldiers and a policeman have been executed by the Islamic State's West Africa province, ISWAP.
81 people were killed when a herder's village was raided in Gubbio. A group of fighters called the Islamic State West Africa province claimed responsibility for that attack.
In terms of the support that the IS has been able to provide to ISWAP, there has been some financial assistance, not very significant, you know, small amounts, but with $50,000 in such a rustic environment, you can actually have a big impact. There's been a lot of advice in terms of military matters, the use of certain equipments. There has been actually a team of trainers sent by the IS that spent several months fighting and reviewing operations, teaching courses in strategy and tactics, and making all sorts of suggestions, including, for instance, in the organization of the media department. But it doesn't mean that the IS calls the shots. It doesn't mean that they decide. You know, ISWAP is not run from Iraq. There's a large degree of autonomy of those local actors in the Lake Chad and in northeast Nigeria. And in a way, some of them have been instrumentalizing the presence of the IS for their internal factional politics.